Demonstrators in downtown Milwaukee last week protesting a plan to make Milwaukee County supervisors part-time. Milwaukee County has the state's only full-time board of supervisors, and there may be no stopping a plan to make those supervisors part-time. It's a Republican bill to dramatically slash the board's pay and budget, and Republicans control the legislature. On this program last week, Governor Walker, the former county executive, said he'd support it. The plan would go to voters in a binding referendum, and most observers predict it would pass. The county board chairwoman has said this is part of a personal vendetta by Milwaukee County Executive Chris Abele. And the county executive joins us now on Upfront. It's good to have you back on the program.
Good to be here, Mike.
Let me have you respond to what the chairwoman says. She said this is personal, that you're not seeing eye to eye on some other issues, and this is the result.
Yeah, no, it's not personal. It's not political. I make the decisions I make based on my interpretation of best public benefit. I like efficient systems. I'm not looking for an enemy. I'm not looking for who to be angry at. I'm looking to get things done. I note, though, that there was a referendum on this issue about 2 years ago now. Shorewood, which is overwhelmingly Democratic, had the lowest approval and still approved both questions 72%. So the people spoke, the board had an opportunity to do something, and they redistricted Joe Rice off of the board. I don't think this is a new issue. I don't think it's a Republican issue or a Democratic issue. It's an efficiency issue.
The argument against it, those who don't like this idea say, Milwaukee County is a big, diverse county. It's unlike other counties. This is going to consolidate a lot of power in your hands, and it's going to remove some of the checks and balances that are necessary. What's your response?
I think that's a ridiculous argument. Milwaukee County is different from the other 71 counties. We are the only full-time board. Two, we are the only board that has a staff on top of a full-time supervisors of 38 and a budget of $6.6 million. But three, this county is 100% incorporated. So everybody who has a supervisor also has a mayor and a common council or a village president. And the people who get constituent calls are those mayors. Issues about permitting, zoning, and development that in rural counties are handled by supervisors, here they're handled by cities and aldermen. I mean, there's much less need.
What about this idea, though, of local control? I mean, you're the Milwaukee County Executive. Do you really want the state stepping in and telling you how the county should be run?
Yeah, no, I've heard this one, too. A local referendum, meaning giving Milwaukee County, not Madison, Milwaukee County citizens the opportunity to vote, is about as local control as it gets. And I just again remind people, 2 years ago, there was a referendum. Milwaukee County residents, Democrat and Republican, overwhelmingly supported making a smaller board and a part-time board, and that was promptly ignored. The state, as you know, we're counties, we're not cities, we don't have home rule. The state does not need our permission to change the structure of county government. They've done it before, they'll do it again. We didn't used to have a county executive. The fact that there's two referendums is the state bending over backwards in the direction of local control.
You're confident this would pass? If it's passed as a piece of legislation and it goes to the voters of Milwaukee County, you're very confident it'll pass?
I think so, yeah. It's hard to see it not.
Yeah. I want to change topics here briefly and ask you about some comments made by Milwaukee County Sheriff David Clarke. We'll play them and then get your response.
I'm Sheriff David Clarke, and I want to talk to you about something personal, your safety. It's no longer a spectator sport. I need you in the game. But are you ready? With officers laid off and furloughed, simply calling 911 and waiting is no longer your best option. You can beg for mercy from a violent criminal, hide under the bed, or you can fight back. But are you prepared? Consider taking a certified safety course in handling a firearm so you can defend yourself until we get there. You have a duty to protect yourself and your family. We're partners now. Can I count on you?
This safety message brought to you by the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office.
What do you think of that?
Well, it struck me as more similar to a trailer for an action movie than a public safety message. You know, if the question is, should people be certified before they own guns? Absolutely, and I'm glad to hear the sheriff acknowledge that there is accountability around the responsibility of owning a gun. I guess the other thought I have is that when people are responding to citizen calls for around public safety, it's not the sheriff's department, it's the Milwaukee Police Department or their local police department, and they do a great job. There was some mention about furloughs. I'm not sure if he's talking about the police department, but I happen to think we have a phenomenal police department with great leadership at the city, and we've got great departments around the county, and I think they do a great job. And I guess...
Is this personal? It seems to be a backhanded slap at you because he doesn't like some of the things you propose in an effort to increase efficiency in this county.
Maybe. I'm not really sure. It's sort of unclear. But, you know, furloughs aren't something, you know, the only thing I can think of is maybe he's talking about the police department. But regardless, if the sole goal was about improving public safety, there's a lot of ways to do it without creating the impression that there is an impending or critical danger right now, which is sort of the tone of the message. I mean, if he wants to talk about encouraging people who are going to handle firearms to get training, that's fantastic, and I applaud it. I happen to agree with the police chief and the mayor that it's time to have the discussion. It's long past time. Making universal background checks, you know, without the gun show exception, the individual seller exception, and getting tougher on people who sell guns illegally.
Milwaukee County Executive Chris Abele, we appreciate your time. Thanks very much for being on the program.
Great to be here, Mike.
The new national health care law will tax medical device makers to help pay for expanded coverage. Coming up next, the CEO of Wisconsin's premier medical device company, GE Healthcare, on how they'll handle the new tax.